Good afternoon, everyone. Now, the compounds preparation here. Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, their preparation and properties, we will see. First, we'll go with the fluorine. So, how to prepare this fluorine? First, preparation. We know that fluorine is a strong oxidizing agent and there is no chemical compound to convert fluoride ion to the fluorine. So, to get the fluorine, generally we have to convert fluoride ion to the fluorine. Means we have to oxidize this fluoride ion to the fluorine compound. But there is no such compound to oxidize the fluoride to the fluorine. Why? Because fluorine only the strongest oxidizing agent. Then how to prepare the fluorine from its halide, that is a fluoride compounds. The best method here we can prepare the fluorine from fluoride is electrolysis process. Simple, by using chemical reactions we cannot prepare the fluorine. The reason, so fluorine is a strong oxidizing agent. So we have to attempt the electrolysis process. This was initially proposed by Meissen, so we can call Meissen method it is. So, by using Meissen method, we can prepare. So, in this method, we will take potassium fluoride, solid potassium fluoride that dissolves in HF liquid. It can form KHF2, one ionic compound. It can give the ions like K plus and HF2 minus. So, due to the more electronegativity of fluorine, it can form strong hydrogen bond and it can form HF2 minus anion. And this compound, if you do the electrolysis at anode oxidation can take place. This HF2 minus can give like HF and F minus. It will be present like this. So, this F minus will move towards anode. It will oxidize at anode and liberates fluorine. And whereas at cathode, we have the K plus and H plus, and H plus is having less reduction potential values, more reduction potential values compared to the K plus. So, hydrogen can liberate at cathode. Anyhow, we required the fluorine. So, we can prepare the fluorine by using this Meissen method where KF and HF mixture, we will take this KHF2. And this substance can be used for the electrolysis process. And now the properties of fluorine, both physical and chemical properties. Now we know that fluorine is a LO gas. And it is a highly reactive in nature and strong oxidizing agent. Is highly reactive. It can act as a powerful oxidizing agent or strong oxidizing agent. So it can replace the halides from their salts, means chlorides, bromides and iodides. If you take some chemical reactions here, you take Cl- with the fluorine due to the strong oxidizing nature and you will get chlorine in here. F minus. So, chlorides can be converted into the compounds. And similarly, bromide. And if you treat with the fluorine, it will oxidize bromide to the bromine. And similarly, iodide. And when you treat with the fluorine, you will get iodine and fluoride. And the reverse reactions are not possible. Why? Because chlorine cannot oxidize fluoride minus. Bromine also cannot oxidize F minus. And iodine cannot oxidize fluorine. Why? Because the oxidizing behavior of halogens, fluorine is the strongest oxidizing agent than chlorine and bromine iodine. So, this one. So always fluorine can oxidize chlorine, bromine, iodine. And chlorine can oxidize bromine, iodine. And bromine can oxidize iodine only. Only the forward direction is possible. Reverse is not possible. Means iodine cannot oxidize bromide and iodine cannot oxidize the Cl like this. So this is very, very important, the oxidizing behavior of fluorine. And due to the high reactive in nature, it can react with metals and non-metals also, but exothermic in nature. We can see the few of reactions here, which are related to the fluorine. Fluorine when reacts with the sulfur, it will form the final product, sulfur hexafluoride. And with oxygen, we know that oxygen, instead of oxides, it can form fluorides. Fluorine is a more electronegative in nature. You get O2F2, oxygen difluoride it is, dioxygen difluoride. And with the carbon, it will form carbon tetrafluoride. So with compound, let us take some silicon dioxide. If you treat with the fluorine, you will get silicon hexafluoride. And one more important reaction here, even it can replace, it can oxidize the chlorate and iodate salts too, perchlorate and iodate salts. We convert into the ClO4 minus or IO4 minus or F minus. So that powerful oxidizing agent. So these are the few reactions of fluorine and their properties. Next to chlorine. Chlorine. Chlorine Cl2. So chlorine was first prepared by the scientist Scheele. This first prepared by the scientist Scheele. And he prepared this chlorine and he treated the manganese dioxide with HCl. You treat HCl with manganese dioxide, found the formation of chlorine. This is one reaction, the preparation of chlorine. Apart from this, some other reactions. Now we can prepare chlorine when you treat sodium chloride with manganese dioxide in presence of sulfuric acid. Again, just like HCl-MnO2, same procedure. But here byproducts are different, chlorine, MnCl2, and you will get sodium bisulfate plus water. Next, third preparation method, potassium permanganate when you treat with HCl. It can give the chlorine, 5 moles of chlorine, KCl, MnCl2. And water. The next one, important preparation method here, this is the name of reaction, is called Dacon's process. again HCl if we treat with oxygen. So HCl if we treat with oxygen in presence of the catalyst, that is cupric chloride, we will get chlorine. And this reaction is called Dacon's process. This is a very important name of reaction. It's called Dacon's process. Dacon's process or Dacon's process. And the next, electrolysis of brine solution. Electrolysis of brine solution, that is aqueous sodium chloride. Aqueous sodium chloride. When you do the electrolysis of aqueous sodium chloride, at anode chlorine can liberate, and at cathode hydrogen will liberate. So you'll get chlorine at anode through the electrolysis process. So these are the few preparation methods of chlorine. Next, properties of chlorine. And we know that chlorine is a greenish yellow gas. Greenish yellow gas. It is also powerful oxidizing agent, but compared to the fluorine, less in nature. It is also strong oxidizing agent. This chlorine also can react with metals, non-metals and some compounds. Let us see few chemical reactions of chlorine. First, oxidizing behavior. It can oxidize bromide to the bromine. You will get bromine. And similarly, it can oxidize iodide to the iodine. These two reactions within the halogens. Next, it can react with non-metals, metals, some reactions with non-metals. Like hydrogen. It can react with a hydrogen in presence of sunlight. It will give HCl. With the sulfur, it can form S2Cl2, a dimeric form of monohalogen. With phosphorus, it can give both PCl3 and PCl5. If you take limited amount, we will get PCl3. If you take excess chlorine, we will get PCl5. And similarly with some metals and metalloids. Take some aluminium, it will give aluminium chloride, and if you treat with sodium, you will get sodium chloride. Some D block metals like copper, if you treat with the chlorine, you will get cupric chloride. And with iron, I will get ferric chloride. So these are the few reactions with some metals and reaction with some compounds. Compounds like hydrogen sulfide, if you treat with the chlorine, I will get HCl and sulfur. And with a hypo, Na2S2O3, hypo. And if you treat with the chlorine, you will get sodium sulfate. Hypo can be oxidized. There is a sodium thiosulfate can be oxidized to the sodium sulfate, sulfur and to HCl. And ferrous sulfates to ferric sulfates. In presence of acidic media, you will get it ferric sulfate. Again, your iron oxidizes to plus 2 to plus 3. And it can oxidize sodium sulfide Na2SO3. Na2SO3 again sodium sulfate, whether it is sodium thiosulfate or sodium sulfide, the final product will get sodium sulfate only. And sulfur dioxide. Can be converted again into the sulfuric acid. And iodine. Iodine can be oxidized to the iodic acid. Here it will give iodic acid. Like these are the few reactions which support the oxidizing behavior of chlorine, the high reactive in nature. And apart from this, it can undergo some addition reactions. Chlorine can undergo addition reactions. Addition reactions like these addition reactions are important when you treat sulfur dioxide with the chlorine. We will get sulfuryl chloride SO2Cl2 directly. And if it is carbon monoxide, we will get carbonyl chloride. This is called phosgene, it is a poisonous gas. Carbonyl chloride. And similarly, if we treat with nitric oxide, we will get nitrosyl chloride. NOCl. Like this. It can show some addition reactions directly. Now, these addition reactions are important. Next, chlorine can react with calcium hydroxide, can give the bleaching powder. And this reaction also very important. When chlorine treat with the calcium hydroxide, two moles of calcium hydroxide, two moles of chlorine. We will get this composition, calcium oxychloride and calcium chloride plus water. And this CaOCl2 and CaCl2, this combination we can call bleaching powder. This is the bleaching powder. We can represent the bleaching powder in another chemical formula also, that is CaOCl2, bleaching powder. Anyhow, here you will get OCl minus ion and here it can give Cl minus. Similarly, calcium oxychloride, it can produce both the Cl minus and OCl minus. There is a bleaching powder composition, we can write CaOCl2. And sometimes we can represent the bleaching powder composition in another manner also. There is a composition of bleaching powder. Composition of bleaching powder. And this is the composition. This is also correct. It is a combination of calcium oxychloride, calcium chloride and calcium hydroxide water. And this is the overall composition of bleaching powder. Normal, we can represent the bleaching powder like this also, calcium oxychloride or this combination, CaOCl2 and CaCl2. So, various representations for bleaching powder. So, very important formula of bleaching powder also very important here. Next one, the bleaching action of chlorine. chlorine can show bleaching property, but the bleaching property is due to its oxidizing behavior, bleaching action. Take the chlorine and dissolve in water, it will give HCl and HOCl. We know that this HOCl further can give the nascent oxygen, and this nascent oxygen is responsible for the oxidizing behavior of the chlorine, and it can decolorize the color matter into the colorless. This is responsible for the bleaching action of chlorine, and this nascent oxygen, and if you treat with colored matter, or colored substances with this nascent oxygen, will get a colorless matter. And this bleaching action, this is also very important point, the bleaching action is due to its oxidizing nature, and it is permanent, whereas in case of sulfur dioxide, already we have discussed, in case of sulfur dioxide, the bleaching action is due to the reducing nature of sulfur dioxide, but that is a temporary, but it is permanent. Is a permanent bleaching property. So again, bleaching action of chlorine is very important. And apart from this, anyhow, reaction with alkali and reaction with ammonia already we have discussed. So I'm not going to discuss again here. But one important point about the disproportionation reaction. Chlorine, when you treat with alkalis, it undergo disproportionation reactions. What are the disproportionation reaction here? Chlorine, when we treat with sodium hydroxide, this is a base, and hot and concentrated, and get chloride ion and chlorate ion. This reaction anyhow we know, but this combination chloride and chlorate ion further, if we treat in presence of acidic media, we will get the chlorine back. And here to here we can call disproportionation reaction, but here to here this is called reverse of disproportionation reaction. That is conproportionation reaction. It is also very important. Conproportionation reaction. Cl minus ClO3 minus in presence of acidic medium, again it will give chlorine. And in dilute condition, acidic condition, that we have taken all the reactions. And a reaction of chlorine with ammonia, that also we did. With excess ammonia, what happens? If you take excess chlorine, what happens? If you take excess ammonia, you will get nitrogen, but if you take excess chlorine, you will get NCl3, explosive product. So we have two here. Chlorine, if we treat with ammonia, here if you take ammonia is the excess, then you will get nitrogen, and if you take chlorine is the excess, then we will get NCl. These reactions we studied already. This is also very, very important reaction, so you should keep in mind. Next, the applications of chlorine here, or uses of chlorine. So many applications are there for chlorine. We can use this as a bleaching agent. So bleaching the fabrics and paper pulps uses, and right, for bleaching fabric, in textile industry mainly we can use this, and paper pulp. Next, in metallurgy of for the extraction of gold and platinum in metallurgical process we can use. Metallurgy of gold and platinum. Metallurgy is nothing but extraction of metals. And then we can use this for the purification of drinking water, for the sterilization process. Sterilizing water. To kill the bacteria in water, we will use this. And also we can use this for the manufacturing of various dyes, drugs and organic chemicals like manufacture of various chemicals like carbon tetrachloride, some insecticides, so DDT, some refrigerants. There's a chlorofluorocarbons, refrigerants, freons, we can prepare by using this chlorine. And also we can use this preparation of some poisonous gases. Preparation of poisonous gases. What are they? Like just now we have discussed, one is the phosgene COCl2, direct addition product. And cheer gas, trichloronitromethane, this is called tear gas, causes tears. And mustard gas, it is also war gas. This is one mustard gas. This preparation of various poisonous gases, we can use chlorine. Next, bromine preparation. We can prepare the bromine. So bromide salts, if it treated with the chlorine, just now we have discussed there is the oxidizing behavior of chlorine. It can replace the bromide and oxidize that into the bromine. Next, one of the contraportionation reaction example, KBr and KBrO3. This is in presence of HCl. Just now we have discussed that chlorine conproportionation reaction. Similarly, bromide and bromate ion in presence of acidic medium, you will get bromine back. Acidic medium, you will get it bromine. For example of the conproportionation reaction. Similarly, you can prepare by using other oxidizing agent like manganese dioxide in presence of acidic medium. That also can give the bromine. So, manganese dioxide is reduced to manganese salt, Mn2+. In plus water. So these are the few preparation methods of bromine. Next, its properties. It is a reddish brown liquid. And it is also acts as oxidizing agent. All halogens anyhow, they can act as oxidizing agents. Again, the properties related to oxidizing agent, oxidizing behavior, it will show like chlorine only. but one extra point here, it is useful to the formation of clathrate compounds. So bromine can form clathrate compounds. Just these are the compounds just we'll use for the entrapment of the gases. They are cage type molecules, host guest molecules, we can say. So with ice or phenols. These points you should remember, remaining chemical properties as usual to the chlorine only. So no need to discuss. Next, iodine. Again, preparation of iodine. So potassium iodide, again if you treat with the chlorine, there is a strong oxidizing agent, and get it liberates iodine. Second one, again conproportionation reaction. Sodium iodide and sodium iodate in presence of acidic media. Just like bromine preparation. We'll get this. And same, similar to the bromine preparation, potassium iodide can treat with the oxidizing agent manganese dioxide. In presence of sulfuric acid, just a almost similar to the bromine only, you will get iodine, potassium disulfate, manganese sulfate, and what? These are the few preparation methods of iodine. And the properties, you know, that is a dark violet solid. Bromine is a liquid, but this is the solid. Whereas the fluorine and chlorine, they are gases. One more important point about this iodine. We know that solubility of iodine is very less in water. The reaction is almost non-spontaneous. But the solubility can be increased in presence of potassium iodide. And this point is very important. Solubility of iodine increases in water in presence of Ki. Why? Because in presence of Ki, it can form Ki3. This iodine will react with potassium iodide, it will form Ki3. So ionic compound, it will be present like this. Ki3 can undergo dissociation like K plus and I3 minus. It's very important. The form of how Ki3 present is K plus and I3 minus. It is not Tk plus and I minus, K plus I3 minus. I3 minus structure anyhow we know. I3 minus ion. The central iodine, it carries a negative charge, 3 lone pairs, and terminal iodine also, they carries the 3 lone pairs. It is a linear structure with the sp3d hybridization, 2 bond pairs and 3 lone pairs. The central iodine sp3 hybridization, if you see, is sp3d hybridization, linear geometry. This is also very important. And the lone pair present in the central iodine is 3 and terminal iodine is also 3. And this is one extra point we should remember with respect to iodine. Apart from this, one more extra point, we know that iodine can be react with sodium thiosulfate, it can form sodium tetrathionate, but the quantitative estimation of iodine. You can take the chemical reaction of iodine.
with sodium thiosulfate. Only we have taken these reactions. Na2S4O6 and iodine will be converted to iodide. And also when it reacts with ammonia, it will form an explosive compound. It will form Ni3 and NH3. This is an explosive compound. This compound and explosion, if we heat it, we will get nitrogen and the red iodine gas, and we will get ammonium iodide, NH4I. So these are the few chemical properties related to the iodine we should keep in mind. Now we'll see oxides of chlorine. Sometimes advanced level we may get the questions from here. Oxides of chlorine, what are the important oxides? The oxides mentioned in the NCERT Cl2O. ClO2, Cl2O6 and Cl2O7, these. And now we will see the preparation and properties of these oxides. First we will go with the preparation. Preparation of chlorine oxides. First, chlorine, if we treat with mercuric oxide, you will get here chlorine monoxide, Cl2O, you will get it. Anyhow, this is a byproduct. We require, the main product is here chlorine monoxide. And similarly, chloric acid, and if we heat it, can undergo thermal decomposition, will give chlorine dioxide, ClO2, plus of O2 and water. Sodium chlorate. From this chloric acid, we'll get this sodium chlorate. But if we treat with sulfur dioxide, in presence of sulfuric acid, we get the same chlorine dioxide, ClO2. Sodium bisulfite. Next, sodium chlorate, same, if you treat with oxalic acid. And like sodium chlorate or potassium chlorate, if you treat with oxalic acid, you will get chlorine dioxide. And the byproducts are sodium oxalate. Not potassium chlorate. So if you treat with the acids, sulfuric acid directly, we will get chlorine dioxide, potassium bisulfate, perchloric acid, HClO4 and water. Silver chlorate. This, if we treat with the chlorine, silver chlorate, that also can give chlorine dioxide. And all these pi reactions related to the chlorine dioxide. So first is for the chlorine monoxide and chlorine dioxide. Now other reactions, chlorine dioxide, if we treat with ozone, we will get Cl2O6. And for the preparation of Cl2O7, you take perchloric acid. That if you treat with a dehydrating agent, P4O10. We know that perchloric acid is anhydride of Cl2O7. Anyhow, this P4O10 will be converted into the metaphosphoric acid by absorbing the water. So these are the few preparation methods of various types of oxides of chlorine. Their chemical properties altogether. Properties. Chlorine monoxide can undergo hydrolysis. Their hydrolysis reactions are very important. You will get hypohalous acid, HOCl. And this chlorine monoxide is called anhydride of HOCl, hypohalous acid anhydride. And similarly, chlorine dioxide can undergo hydrolysis, which will give halous acid and halic acid, means chlorous and chloric acid we will get it. We will get two oxy acids of chlorine, and this ClO2 is called mixed anhydride. Mixed anhydride of these two. Mixed anhydride of chlorous acid and chloric acid. Similarly, Cl2O6. This if we hydrolyze it, we will get a chloric acid and perchloric acid. So this one gives the chloric and perchloric. Again, we can say it is also mixed anhydride. These two, ClO2 and Cl2O6, both are the mixed anhydrides. So mixed anhydride of both these. And the last one here, Cl2O7. This, if we hydrolyze it, we will get perchloric acid. Just now we discussed. So, this chlorine, dichloroseptor, that is oxide, called anhydride. Of this perchloric acid. These four oxides are corresponding and which what type of anhydride they are, so that we should remember. One other reaction here for chlorine monoxide, when it reacts with ammonia, it will form ammonium chloride and releases nitrogen. So these are the some chemical properties of the chlorine oxides. Next, structures of this chlorine oxide. This is also important, structures. First one, Cl2O, chlorine monoxide. Here, oxygen is the central atom. Oxygen undergo sp3 hybridization, and with the angular shape, two bond pairs are there, and here the bond angle will be 111 degrees. This bond angle also should remember in case of chlorine monoxide, 111. Next, chlorine dioxide. Structure of chlorine dioxide is like this. Will donate a pair of electrons. has one lone pair, one single electron. This chlorine carries one single electron, total 7 electrons. And so ClO2 is a paramagnetic in nature. And then again the angular shape. The bond angle here is 118 degrees. Because a double bond, single bond repulsions.
Sir, angular.
Angular. Cl2O6. It has two types of forms. It's a chlorine-chlorine bond. It's kind of tetrahedral in geometry. This is one kind of representation, or we can represent like this with a bridged form. Again, same tetrahedral in geometry only. This oxygen may form the coordinate bond. It can donate a pair of electrons to the vacant d orbital of chlorine. Actually, this is a monomeric form of ClO3. ClO3 can undergo dimerization, it will give Cl2O6. Last one, Cl2O7. The structure of Cl2O7 is like this. Again, it is tetrahedral in geometry. With one oxygen linkage. This is Cl2O7. They are the structures of all this chlorine oxide.